Hello, welcome to my channel. This is Pawan Kumar. In this session, we will be dealing with fundamentals of Kotlin programming language. Quickly move on to our agenda. So, introduction to Kotlin, what are the features of Kotlin, a basic syntax, and the differences between Java and Kotlin, lambda expressions and anonymous functions, and finally, higher order functions in Kotlin. So, what is a Kotlin programming language? So, it was introduced by JetBrains in the year 2011. So, Kotlin is a cross-platform, statistically typed, and general-purpose programming language with a type inference. That is, a Kotlin is designed to interoperate fully with Java. A Kotlin is a new programming language which runs on JVM, that is Java Virtual Machine, and can be compiled to Java source code. So, Kotlin is widely used to develop Android application. That is, if you have a basic knowledge of Java, you will be able to learn the Kotlin also. So, it is fully supported programming language on Android with Android 3.0 beta version. So, Google has announced an official support for the Kotlin programming language for Android app development also. Now, what are the features of Kotlin? The features of Kotlin includes a tool-friendly, interoperable with Java, concise, easy to learn, and null safety. So Kotlin is more concise and reduces the amount of boilerplate code. That is, for example, whenever we create a POJO classes, that is plain old Java object classes, these classes comes when we are dealing with struts and hibernates. So, instead of creating a POJO classes with getter and setter methods and equals and hash code method, whatever, everything can be run in a single line using a Kotlin. So, Kotlin is 100% interoperable with the Java language, which means we can easily call the Java code from Kotlin and as well as Kotlin code from Java. Kotlin is an open source and will avoid the null pointer exception or null reference exception also, and Kotlin has an open access to the source code, and IntelliJ IDEA plugin is the Kotlin's native IDE for running the Kotlin programs. Now, the basic syntax. Coming to the basic syntax of the Kotlin, it starts with a function with a main. The same as in a Java programming language, that is a public static void main. If at all we are passing the parameters in a command line, we are going to use the args. Otherwise, we can call the main function as an empty. So, we are going to print our own messages. So, this is the basic syntax of a Kotlin program. Now, coming to the differences between Java versus and Kotlin, that is, Java has a checked exception, static members, non-private fields, primitive data types, ternary operator, and wildcard types. So, these are not in Kotlin, whereas Kotlin has lambda expressions, inline functions, extension functions, singletons, first class delegation, range expressions, operator overloading, and string templates. Operator overloading is also present in Python. So, these are the features which contain the Kotlin apart from Java. So the key aspects include: Kotlin is one of the best programming language for the developing Android applications, and Kotlin is used in data science and server-side development and web development. Kotlin is the largest programming language. It is a combination of both Python and Java. So I quickly move on to my editor for running my basic Kotlin program. So this is the editor, IntelliJ IDEA. So whenever we are doing any Kotlin program, go to the option file and select new and select the option project. In that select Kotlin, or you can select Java. So in that select Kotlin slash JVM. So Kotlin Java runtime. Using this library, the Kotlin programs are going to be executed. So this is the basic program. I will be running my code here first. So, the JVM is loading. Yeah, so hello world. So, this is the first basic program of Kotlin. So, coming to the other fundamental programs of Kotlin, I will open my presentation mode here. Yeah, so the first basic program, which includes accepting the input from the user. So, in order to accept the input from the user, Kotlin uses a method called readLine and convert it into int using toInt method. Same as in Unix, in order to get the value in a variable, Kotlin also uses a dollar symbol to return the value. So, we'll run the code first. So it asks for the number, that is user input. So the value which I have entered is the output it has given. So project finished with exit code 0. So this is the first program for accepting the input from the user. So I will highlight this one and I will run the second program. Calculating the product of two numbers. So these are the basic program for user interaction. So I have taken the two variables, that is first and second, and I will be producting the two numbers and I will be printing the value. So the product is 4316. So this is a second basic program. Now coming to the division, same old, we have taken the two variables and perform the division operation. We are going to print both quotient as well as the remainder. So I will be running the code. So yeah, see, you can clearly see that public inline function println, that is Kotlin, definitely gives whenever we are creating any method or predefined or user defined, Kotlin will give a help about that method and as well as variables also. So the quotient is 6 and the remainder is 1. I have taken the two numbers 25 and 4. So variables are dividend and divisor. So I will be performing the division operation and I will be printing the values. So this is the third one. So let's highlight this. So same as in all other programming languages, a swapping also can be performed in Kotlin. So which includes taking the values, that is first and second. The values are initialized with 14 and 22. So before swapping, I will be printing the values and I will be taking a temporary variable and performing the swapping operation and finally printing the values after swapping. So before swapping as well as after swapping. So this is an example of a swapping in Kotlin. Coming to accepting the input from the user and checking whether the number is even or odd. So say the number is divided by 2, that is modulus, and we'll be checking whether the number is even or odd. So next in method is used to get the input from the user. So which is a method of reader class. So it will ask for the number. The 74 is even. So the project will be finishing. So in this way, we can check whether the number is even or odd. So same as in all other programming language, Kotlin also contains the if loop. Yeah. So this program is replica of above program. So we, instead of accepting the input, I have taken a predefined value and checking whether the number is a negative or positive. So this is an example of an if-else program. It is an example of else-if ladder. So 17 is a positive number. So in this way, we can perform the else-if operations, that is else-if in Kotlin. Now coming to printing the sum of the numbers. So take an initial number of, let me say 16. So add the numbers. For I in 1 means I equal to 1. In Kotlin language, I in 1 means the value of I is initialized with 1. So two dots represents I in 1 to the number, that is 16. So that's, from 1, the 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus so on until the value of 16 is going to be added. The sum is going to be printed. So in this way, sum to n numbers is going to be done in Kotlin. Now coming to the factorial. We can give any number here, since Kotlin has a method called toLong which will convert the value into a long method. So it will give in the help also. So public open function for toLong method. So convert this int value to long number. So I will be running the code here. So the factorial of 50 is, so we can get the factorial of 50. Now that is first 10 terms, that is I will be taking a Fibonacci series. For user understanding, I have written this program. So here zero, starting with the numbers 0, 0 and 1. So for first 5 terms, so I will be printing the Fibonacci series. You can even get the values also using a dollar symbol. You can get the value. I will be just printing the values. So finally, checking whether the number is a prime or not. I have already taken the input value, that is 20, and I'll be checking whether the number is prime or not. Yeah, 20 is not a prime number. Now I will exit my presentation mode. Yeah, so we will open our project. So coming to the next program, lambda. So I already seen, I already what as a lambda expressions in a Kotlin. So the syntax for lambda expressions is, there is a lambda name, data type, argument list, followed by the CRO. That is, a lambda expression is always surrounded by a curly braces and argument declarations, and go inside the curly braces and have an optional type annotations. That is, the code body goes after an arrow sign. So the code body is going to be represented after the arrow sign. So the lambda expressions and anonymous functions are the functions. So these functions are not declared but passed immediately after an expression. That is, a function without any name is called as an anonymous function. So the lambda expressions are identically equal to anonymous functions. So I already opened another program. That's why it is showing the error. Yeah. I will run the first lambda program, lambda expressions program. So this is a lambda expression. Yeah, calling the method company two times. So company dot invoke. So company. So we can call the method company, or we can use a method called as an invoke for invoking the company method. So in two ways we can use, we can call the method that is company. I will highlight the code. So this is a basic syntax for lambda expressions. So this is second type of lambda expression, that is without type annotation in lambda expression and with type annotation in lambda expression. That is, we are going to mention the type, that is integer types here. Here we are not going to mention the integer types. So in the main function, I will be calling these two functions, that is sum1 and sum2, and I will be passing the value and I will be getting the output for sum, that is result1, and for the second sum, that is result2. I think it is not closed here. Yeah. Let me run the code again. Yeah. So the sum of two numbers is 62 and 34. So here you can clearly see that two types of lambda expression, that expression is going to be taken, one without annotation and one with annotation. So this is an example of a lambda expressions in Kotlin. Now coming to the higher order functions. So higher order functions in Kotlin means we can pass the functions as an arguments to other functions. That is, we can pass one function as an argument another function, and we can also return a function from another function. So these functions are termed as higher order functions in Kotlin. So here an example is taken by passing a lambda expression to a function. So I will be running the code first. So this is the lambda expression and this is the function. Call me is the function. So here I passed a lambda expression to a function. So I will be getting the message as hello. So this is an example of higher order function. That is, we can pass the function as an argument to another function. So Kotlin also deals with the collections also. That is, a collection framework which is in Java, the same collection framework in Kotlin. Here I taken a list value which includes the person names. Here first I defined a function, that is a person. So it clearly shows the public final data, that is a class person. So we are not going to mention the public final, which is default in Kotlin. Name as well as age, that is a key as well as value, which is a key value pair, which is identically equal to a hash map or a dictionary. So I will be getting the value for the person whose age is highest age, I will be returning the value. So that's why I will be, that is dollar selected person dot name selected person dot age. Using this we can get the value. So this is an example of a collection framework in a Kotlin. Now coming to the return value, first I will run the code first. I'll be debugging here. So here I have taken a function, so which will returns which will return a value. Whenever I pass an integer value, it will be checking whether the number is even or negative, even or positive, some other conditions. So I will be passing from the main function here. So find is the function which is going to be called. So it will directly goes to the find function, and finally the value is going to be returned. So this is an example of return value in Kotlin, that is returning the value using a function. So given number is even and a positive. Now coming to the adding list. So how can we add a two lists in Kotlin? Here I have taken two lists, that is list one and list two. So for list one contains some strings, or let me say the characters, and list two contains some characters. So I am going to add these two lists using a method called as addAll. So addAll method will be adds the two lists. So here I have taken a variable called as join. So I'll let run the code first. Yeah, so here the two lists are going to be joined. First addAll of list one means the value of list one, that is a characters, is going to be stored in join, which is going to be appended for list two. So in this way we can add two lists in Kotlin. Coming to the nullable, that is null pointer exception, that is divide 0 by 0 or any type of exception is going to be handled in Kotlin. First let me run the code here. Here I have taken a list which contains certain strings. So I will be printing the values. So this is an example of a nullable, or we can even get the value from the keyboard also, that is user also. It clearly avoids a null pointer exceptions. See, whenever we are going to use any divided by zero, that is 0 by 0 also, Kotlin will directly throw it as null pointer exception. So we are not going to write any type of try, catch or finally statements in Kotlin. Now coming to anonymous function. So clearly I have seen what is a lambda function. So there is a basic difference between lambda expressions and anonymous functions. So an anonymous function is very similar to a regular function, except the name of the function which is omitted from the declaration. So we are not going to give the name of the function, but the differences between the lambda expressions and anonymous function is using of a return statement. That is, whenever we use a return statement inside a lambda expression, it will return from the enclosing function. Whenever we are going to return inside an anonymous function, it will return from anonymous function itself. That is, it will directly comes out of anonymous function. So here anonymous function with body as an expression and anonymous function with body as a block. So like the same way we can declare lambda function, lambda expressions in two ways, anonymous functions also can be declared in two ways. So that is, with body as an expression and with body as a block. Let me run the code first. So first anonymous function will add the values, and second anonymous function will multiply the values. So addition and multiplication. So in this way, we can define the anonymous function in two ways, with body as an expression, with body as a block. The difference comes whenever the return statement is came, that is, return statement inside a lambda expression will return from the enclosing function, whereas return in anonymous will return from anonymous function itself. Now coming to the correction. So as Java contains the correction framework, as I already said, Kotlin also contains a mapping, that is a dictionary, that is hash map. So we can clearly see that key value pair here. A hash map, which is a predefined class in Kotlin, which adds the key list and as well as the values. So we can retrieve the keys and values which we are going to be using in Kotlin. So these are the basic fundamental programs of Kotlin, which includes a lambda expressions, higher order functions, collections and returning values, nullable expressions, and how adding the lists, and anonymous function. That is, there is a big difference between lambda and anonymous functions, and hash map. So I quickly get back to my slide. So it is one of the best programming languages for developing Android applications. So Kotlin is used in data science and server side development and web development. So it is a combination of both Python and Java. So hope you guys understand with this session. Thank you.